quoting Linus Torvalds, in real open source, you have right to control your own destiny. Namaskaram everyone, welcome to Open Source Wave. I'm Swapnil Mane, and in this video, we are going to talk about what is open source, how open source term was coined, and what makes a piece of software open source. Let's start with what is open source. Open source software are those whose source code is publicly available to everyone. Anyone can freely use it, modify it, and redistribute it. Let's understand each term individually. Source code. A source code is the soul of a software. Most of the user never see the source code. They use the software. But behind every software, there is a source code which is compiled, transpiled, or interpreted by the browser. In open source, this source code is made available in the public domain, so everybody can see what's written in the code. Let's take an example of food dish. A food dish is a final thing which you consume. But what is the soul of a food dish? It is its recipe. If you make its recipe available in the public domain, anybody can prepare that dish. Open source is something like this. Now let's see how open source software can be freely used, modified, and redistribute. Using it. Since the source code is available in the public domain, anybody can inspect the code and use it. Also, if you want to make any changes in the software, you can also do that. For example, if you found any bug, you can fix it and contribute back. Also, you can implement new features. In this way, you can modify the software. The modified version of software can be redistributed. You have a right to redistribute this modified version of software. So this was all about how an open source software can freely use, modify, and redistribute. Now let's talk about how open source term was coined. Initially, the free software word was widely used, but there was a problem with this word. When business hear this word, they thought the software will be cheap, unusable, and worthless. And also they thought they couldn't make money out of it. At the same time, this word was confusing for newcomers as well. They assumed the free was referring to the price and money, but which was not the case. The free word was referring to the freedom. So this was the issue that needs to be addressed. On February 1998, a group assembled at VA Research, and during this meeting, open source term was coined. The credit of inventing this term goes to Christine Peterson, and we are really thankful to her for this invaluable contribution. Now let's talk about what makes a software open source. Just making the source code available in the public domain doesn't make a software open source. Author have to give the rights to user to freely use it, modify it, and redistribute it. Now the question is, how author can do this? The answer is simple, by adding an open source license file in the source code. In brief, open source license allows software to be freely used, modify, and redistribute. There are various open source licenses available like Apache, GNU, MIT, etc. Like if you are having a driving license, you are legally allowed to drive in the respective nation. Similarly, if a source code have open source license file, it allows users to freely use it, modify it, and share it. So this was some brief about the open source. If you'd like to see video on any open source topic, please let us know in the comment section. And also if you like the video, please give us a thumbs up. We would like to thank our generous sponsors for their kind support. Thank you so much everyone.